Good afternoon, YouTubers. Today we're going to show you something that's really ultra rare. And I do mean ultra rare. This is a Ristaucrat, not the typical Ristaucrat that you would normally see. This is a background music / PA system. And they were available only by special order during 1950 and 1951. And they're kind of unique. And quite frankly, this is the first one I've seen. And I've done quite a bit of collecting over the years. This came out of a restaurant in Wisconsin. In fact, two of them were bought by the same restaurant in Wisconsin. And I managed to get both from the previous owner of the restaurant. We had this one, and he also had a backup. This is the better condition of the two. And if we look at this here, I'm going to show you in this area here, it says tone, volume, mic, and phono, and a phono input. And this predates, of course, hi-fi. Although it has very good tone, volume, and it sounds pretty good. There's no built-in speaker system, and you'll notice that this is the chamber, or the changer mechanism. This is typical of the Ristaucrat. This is what you would see is the dial to dial in the number of plays that you want, including continuous music. Now you'll note that the case is green with this model green and cream, I guess you'd call it, as a secondary color. And even the knob on this thing is green. Now that's unusual because most times they're black. This is the first time I've ever seen a green one on a Ristaucrat. It's got a little knob on the front, and if we take a look inside, there's the typical changer that you would see in any Ristaucrat. And in this area, underneath here, is a really burly amplifier. The amplifier that's in here is very large, as you can see by the size of the container that holds it. And I should have taken the other one out just to show you, but the bottom line is it features a 5U4G rectifier. It's got a 6SN7, a 6J5, and a pair of 6V6 GTs in push-pull configuration. So it has a ton of power. And we're going to pump it through this KLH speaker here. Certainly not an exotic speaker. The cabinet looks kind of crappy because it is crappy. But it sounds good. So let's give you a little demonstration here. I'm going to put three records on, and remember that the music you hear is not for the content, but rather to demonstrate how the player works. So once we put it on, we're going to cycle it. Let's move it on to the next record, and you'll notice this feels for a record before it drops it. If it doesn't feel record, it restacks the entire stack, as you'll see in a minute.
Oh, let me go, let me.
Thank you. Now watch as the arm above the, right here, see how it comes down? It's looking for a record, it didn't feel one, so it raises the entire stack, and it'll start right over again, dependent upon the number of records you place in there to be played. I'm just going to swing this on over to the stop position here, or the off position. You'll note that there is a place that says continuous music, which would be in the opposite direction. So while this is playing in the restaurant, and here's what really sucks, it only holds 12 records. Even with a lowrider cartridge, you've only got 12 songs. And you can imagine having to work in that restaurant listening to those same friggin' 12 songs one right after another. So for obvious reasons, these really didn't catch on. These would have predated the Seberg library units. Now Seberg had a library unit out. It was 50 records. They were 78s, but it was a big monster. This at least could sit on a table. And then a short while later, in 1953, they introduced the 200 play. It was still a good size model, but at least you could put it on a table somewhere, and that would play 200 play. It was 100 on one side and 100 on the back side. This obviously is just 14 play, take it or leave it. And of course, with the mic input in the front, you were able to plug a mic in there and hail the next couple. You know, for instance, Sykes' Party of Two, and then you go back to the phono operation to play the music again. But for obvious reasons, these didn't catch on. So it makes them extremely rare, almost impossible to find. So I'm really happy to show you something like this. Very few people ever get to see one, let alone play with one. I do have another. It's not as in good shape as this. I plan to restore that, and it will most likely be up for sale at some point. But this one stays in my collection. It's unique, it's odd, it's different, it plays good. And what more can I say? Thanks again for checking in, and I hope to see you again. We're going to show you some more cool stuff later on this year. Take it easy now.